down the promises you haven't for some time. All the normal answers would call for her to know.
You're the only one. Goodbye. So I saw Miss Hershey standing behind the powerhouse at the corner of Clark and Fifth Avenue. I whipped out my whopper and whispered, "Hey, sweetheart, how'd you like to crunch in my big hunk for $1 million bar? She immediately went down to my Tootsie Roll. You know, it was like pure almond joy. I couldn't help but to grab her delicious mounds, cause it was easy to see that this little Twix had the red hots. It was all I could do to hold back a snicker and a crackle as my butterfinger went up her tight little Kit Kat as she started to scream, "Oh, Henry, oh, Henry." So when she was fondling my Peter Paul and Zag Nuts, and I knew it wouldn't be long before I blew my milk duds clear to Mars and gave her a taste of the old Milky Way, she asked me if I was into M&M's, and I said, "Chiclet, no kinky stuff." I said, "Look, you little Reese Piece, don't be a zero, be a lifesaver. Why don't you just take my whatchamacallit and slip it up your bit of honey?" Oh, what a piece of juicy fruit she was, too. She screamed, "Oh, Cracker Jack, you're better than the Three Musketeers." As I ran my ding-dong up her rocky road into her peanut butter cup, well, I was giving it to her good and plenty when all of a sudden my star burst. Yes, luck would have it, she started to grow a big chunky and complain of a wriggly in her stomach. Sure enough, 9 months later, out popped a baby Ruth.